I want to start with expressing main components of recirculating aquaculture systems. After these basic definitions, we will evaluate site selection, constitution, and RAS management. Aquaculture is a growing industry striving to satisfy a growing market for food fish. It currently is one of the fastest growing sectors of aquaculture in the world. Recirculating aquaculture systems represent a new and unique way to farm fish instead of the traditional method of growing fish outdoors in open ponds and raceways. This system rears feed high densities in outdoor tanks in controlled environment. Recirculating aquaculture systems are using in all over the world for fish production where the water exchange is limited or with the aim of water saving. RAS dramatically reduces the amount of water that used in aquaculture and space required to mass production. First experimental systems were established in Japan and Europe. In 80s, recirculating aquaculture systems that used commercially were used in the Netherlands, Denmark and Germany in the first time. You can see water reuse rates. If it possible that water can be reused up to 90 or 95% in recirculating aquaculture systems. Why recirculate? Because conserves water, permits high density culture in locations where space and or water are limited, minimizes volume of effluent facilitating waste recovery, and also increased control over the culture environment, especially indoors, improved biosecurity and environmentally sustainable system. Functional parts of the RAS contains growing tanks, sump of particulate removal device, mechanic filters, biofilter, sterilization unit, mostly UV or ozone, oxygen injection, water circulation pumps, and heating and cooling systems. Water quality can change due to stock size, feeding regime or species, as you know it, and it should be kept in optimum. In aquaculture recirculating systems, first of all, dissolved or non-dissolved waste is captured and removed by the mechanic filters. After that, ammonia removed feed biofilter using by nitrification bacteria. After that, saturated gases, especially carbon dioxide, is removed and oxygenation applied, and ultimately water sterilized and given to the system again. In this picture, you can see basic RAS design similar to our Black Sea Trout unit. Water collected from tanks and flew through the mechanic filters. This mechanic filter system can be have sand, drum, automatic filter, or combination of them. Later, water came to biofilter for nitrification. After that, similar to previous slide, degassing and aeration stage be carried out. Beside the consideration target species, heating or cooling system can be used. Also, in marine systems, protein skimmer can be used. When we hear RAS, we talk generally supply water usage, but some river-based open flow facilities use RAS when the water quality is reduced in water sources, especially in summertime due to heating. In similar situation, a settlement tank can be used to prevent access of sand and slime materials carried by the river. You can see some settlement tank designs. Tanks are usually made of fiberglass, molded plastic polyethylene, high density polyethylene plastic covered, concrete or iron sheet material. And these materials should be non-toxic and non-corrosive, both in freshwater and saltwater. The interior of the tanks should be smooth in order to help cleaning of the tanks and safe environment for fish. Bottom of the tank should be flat or slightly inclined to one side, allowing workers to work safely. Little observation window can be placed edge of the tank as in the picture. This observation window is very helpful because when you want to check fish, you can use this window, avoiding to put fish on stress. Design should allow self-cleaning. Water current inside to the tank should be designed to collect waste exits of the tank. Circular tank system is more preferred in RAS systems. However, biggest downside of circular tanks is loss of space. Also, the direction of entering pipe can be changed for the need because water circulation directly affected for the water intake. You can see water circulation in circular tanks. In small tanks, circulation is more homogeneous than bigger tanks. This can be prevented with water flow and drainage adjustment in bigger tanks. Besides, double drainage use also have homogeneous circulation. You can use very several water intake options according to target. And with right water intake, you can help water circulation. As you can see in the first photo, pipes located horizontally with tank with the aim of generating circulations. This kind of replacement allow to performing circulation homogeneous. Water transmission, PVC and ABS pipes which are non-toxic and durable are used in water transmission and discharge. PVC is amongst the most preferred and durable piping material, also cheapest one in the world aquaculture. You can use very different piping styles considering your plan and budget. ABS pipes, which is acrylonitrile-butadiene string, is a solid pipe system and can be used in very different temperature ranges. If you have severe temperature changes in your system, you can use this pipe system. The most important things on choosing of a pump in usage area. In aquaculture, pumps both used in fresh water and salt water. All pumps should be durable to wide range of salinity, of course. Besides, pump and components should be formed of stainless steel, fiberglass, plastic or similar durable materials. There is an important issue also is existing pump usage. Pumps are responsible for high amount of electric usage in reciprocating aquaculture system. So when constituting the system, you should select a pump doing the same job as possible with using less pumps. This will be more profitable. In filtration types, sump filter is used for the removal of suspended matter as well as floating and sinkable particles. Water passed through the rapid gravity with sump filter filled with different sizes of sump particles and they kept floating particles trapped within it, reducing numbers of bacteria and removing most of the solids in system. Drum filter, this is a drum filter, simple drum filter. Drum filter mostly located in the beginning of the water flow. It helps to catch more big size materials. It is used in liquids with a high solid content, which could clog other forms of filter. One of the most important things in drum filter selection is backwash availability. If you have backwash, your filter can clean itself quickly and water flow will continue in this cleaning process. You can see water flow direction in drum filter, water flow with rotation of the drum filter and same time water filtered. The ideal filtration stem should be 200 microns to 1 microns. If you use RAS in incubation, you should use up to 5 to 1 microns because same size particles can be full pores of the fish egg. However, if you use RAS in growth stock management, you can use bigger microns. They should operate with highest or lowest water flow rates. Because filtration should be still working very low water, any reducing or increasing the water supplies should not stop filtration system. Also, corrosion resistant materials should be preferred. This is important thing in all materials. Mechanic filtration. High stocking density and feeding cause high amount of solid waste. This waste should be discharged from the system with some basic mechanic filtration systems. These ours belongs to our system. First photo is automatic filter having 25 microns filter and pump. It pumping water from the biofilter and give it to the back filters. The first back filter is 10 microns and second one is 5 microns. In our system, we have two pairs of back filters parallelly because when we want to change the back filters, we change the water flow firstly and give it to the next back filter pair. With this backup, water flow is never stopped in the back water back filter changing. And in our ideal situation, should be clean itself automatically, can be operated with wide ranges of pressure. It needs minimum flow rate for the cleaning process. It should give permission to water flow when the cleaning process on. Protein skimmer. Protein skimmer is using for removal of dissolved organic materials and suspended particles originated from protein wastes, such as feed, feces and secretion. This system creates bubbles with mixing of air and water, and these bubble-like structures pick up those suspense materials up to the surface. Mostly protein skimmer is using in marine freshwater units. Besides, protein skimmer helps reducing ammonia content and pH stability with removing organic acids. Biofilter. Biofilter is mandatory for the rest and I think most important thing to have in the RAS. The biofilter using primarily for ammonia and nitrate removal. Also, it helps to removal of organic dissolved organic materials, removal of carbon dioxide and other dissolved gases and suspended soils. Also helps to oxygenation. Feed addition and fish wastes are increased organic wastes, and this cause high ammonia. And this high ammonia content, this ammonia changed which can be changed to the water pH. Prevent this, some nitrification bacteria cultured into biofilter into biogas. Nitrification bacteria are responsible for converting toxic ammonia to non-toxic and volatile nitrate. Mostly used species are Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter. Nitrosomonas convert ammonia to nitrate and Nitrobacter convert nitrate to nitrate. In RAS, you can see biobas in biofilter. Biobas are using as a substrate for bacterial growth. These are should be non-toxic and have an extensive surface area. You can see biobas design as having large surface area and different shapes. These are necessary for successful cultivation of nitrification bacteria. Some studies suggest that use of lactobacillus species, chlorella and some aquaponic plants can help nitrification process along with Nitrosomonas and Nitrobacter. In this picture, you can see pH increasing parallel with ammonia rising. There is an important thing with changing pH, also toxicity of ammonia rises. You can see in the picture one kilogram of feed that we used in RAS responsible for these values. In fish culture, with uneaten feed, solid and dissolved feces, carbon dioxide generated from respiration can change to the water quality, as you know. And only 1 kilogram of feed is responsible for these values. RAS management. management of dissolved gases. There is direct relationship between oxygen and consumption and feeding and growth. If oxygen is not enough, growing decrease, growth time can be longer, and this can be cause of decrease in the potential benefit. Also, some studies said that, especially in recirculating systems, FCR can be reduced with increased saturated oxygen in water. These are simple oxygenation units having pressure and gas flow methods. Second one is oxygenation cone. Oxygen given to the upper side of the cone and oxygenate to water, and water given to the system in the bottom of the cone. Carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is produced by the respiration of fish and bacteria, and the product is directly related to the amount of oxygen consumed. For every 1 gram of oxygen consumed, 1.27 gram of carbon dioxide is produced in recirculating systems. Carbon dioxide reacts with water to form carbonic acid, and that is reduced pH. In nature, carbonic acid tampon with calcium and precipitated as calcium carbonate. Open systems is more safe with this regard, but in RAS we have limited water and pH can reduce quickly. High levels of carbon dioxide in the as well as carbonic acid in the recirculating system cause the reducing in fish blood pH, which is weakens the oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin even if at high levels of dissolved oxygen. A well-designed gas separation device needs to be installed and removed to carbon dioxide. These are different degassing solutions. These are very simple but effective solutions, as you saw. Heat control. Heating of circulated water is one of the primary environmental factors affecting growth rate, operational cost, and optimum growth. Sometimes you want to cool the water instead of heating, especially in salmonid productions. All heating and cooling equipment must have temperature control systems. In recirculating aquaculture system, natural energy sources such as sunlight, saltwater pools, and groundwater can also be used to control the water temperature. Disease control. A high stocking density can be cause some disease outbreaks. Bacteria, virus, parasite, and etc. should be monitored regularly. RAS more safe than other conventional systems in terms of disease outbreaks. However, when any disease outbreak occurs, management of this is very hard. Because it is closed system, we have biofilter, and for this reason we can't use any antibiotics or chemicals due to potential harmful effects to the nitrification bacteria. So our main target is prevent any disease outbreaks. For this reason, we use sterilizers. The most used sterilizer is UV and ozone. An ideal UV should select it for size of the target organism, flow rate, UV exposure time, and light intensity. Ozone, using especially in saltwater RAS units equipped with protein skimmer. Ozone, which is strong oxidative, is also helps disease control and improving water quality. Ozone can be equipped before the mechanic filter instead of UV and improve performance of mechanic filter, mostly used in marine units, and also it can help to increase of oxygen in the water, but in optimal dosages. Also, you can have some supportive units such as power sources, microscope and other laboratory equipment, storage and personal buildings, quarantine and observation units, and alarm and control units. In this photo, you can see a simple remote control unit. Researchers can control all of the water quality changes in this system with probes. Also, I want to show this portative unit. As you know, any filter-equipped aquarium can define the simple RAS. However, as you can see, these are more complex and seems like more scientific. They use aquaponic plants or simple barrels filled with biobas for the filtration. All of these can be said that simple RAS. I want to explain some important things in RAS constitution. Selection of water source is important, especially nowadays, minimum demand on limited water sources. The limited quantity of high quality water in aquifers show that water recirculation systems will become increasingly important for the aquaculture in the future. Especially due to climate change, we need more reused water in the future. Water quality can be maximized in RAS with aeration, degassing units, or nitrification. Besides, water temperature can be maintained at the optimum level for fast growth and optimum feed conversion according to target species. However, some parameters that can be changed with RAS, such as heavy metals or other toxic substances exist in water. So equipment should be considered when the water source is selection. Water quality must be appropriate to culture condition of target species as well as human health. RAS has minimum environmental impact. Recirculating systems permit the concentration and removal of fish waste so that water pollution can be controlled and minimized. So it can be established in all zones, especially in sensitive environments. By the way, there is a concerning issue in the European Commission agenda. They established good environmental status in this year. This concerns on harmful and toxic substances, seafood and surrounding waters. According to these working papers, researchers should monitor three toxic elements, cadmium, lead, mercury, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, dioxin and radionuclides. Some studies show that radionuclides exist in Black Sea, PAH and dioxin contaminations as known already for years. So in near future, we can confront with contamination of these materials in aquaculture productions. And to eliminate such risks, we should carefully select in bulk stock origin, feed selection and water source for avoiding such risk. The previous slide, loss caused from environmental effects such as predators, pollutants and disease is lower in RAS than the other production systems. However, in case of any contamination, these systems can be affected more compared to other systems. To eliminate this risk, these systems can be built in disease and pollutant free zones and operated with carefully. As a regulation of the aquaculture and the water usage should be assessed in constitution of RAS. However, few government permits are required in RAS because of limited impact on environment and limited withdrawal of wastewater. Few permits are required for the aquaculture system based on water recirculation. Besides, some countries, as well as our country, help financially to building of RAS. This kind of regulations can be helpful for the producers also. Size selection, closed systems can be located near the markets. Suitable size for other systems are dependent on location of water or land sources. However, recirculating systems can be located anywhere. Recirculating systems are perceived as can be constituted any places due to minimum space requirements for production. In comparison to other types of systems, closed systems require very little space. However, demand on capacity extensions of RAS equipments are increasing parallel with increasing of stock size in mass production. For this reason, production plans and system capacity, considering possible extensions, should be well planned and executed in the first time. Recirculating systems has significant operating costs. Closed systems requires pumping water through tanks and filters. Besides, water cost due to daily water loss up to the 10% can be significant, especially in the bigger productions. We mentioned before several times last to such reduce water use. Similar to our system, if you take daily replenish water amount from city supply, there is increase can be occur in your cost. However, this cost can be affordable considering your production size parallel with profit, or some adjustments can be done that reduce daily replenish of water amount. Also, the operating and maintenance cost of pumps are significant, and this cost may be the difference between profitable and non-profitable fish farms. For avoiding such operating costs, experienced and competent technical personnel should be preferred. Also, personnel should be trained and become an expert operating RAS. You can see, according to a FAO report, you can see cost distribution of the trout culture in recirculating aquaculture system. Approximately half of the cost caused by feeding. When we consider energy, depreciation and maintenance, which are known as cost, high capital cost in those units, we saw that they compose only 22 of the total cost. I don't think that is too much because any open flow system will have same operational cost in these expenses, especially and same feed usage. Capital cost of buildings, pumps, tanks and heaters are higher than other production systems. Thus, parallel with other with aforementioned headline, system should be well planned and researchers should avoid unnecessary equipment in constitution of system. Circulating system can be used in both fresh and water, both fresh and salt water, as you know. Salt water usage in DRAS is a growing industry according to FAO reports, especially some sensitive species to the environment conditions such as turbot are culturing in salt water recirculating units, and they reach target size more quicker than the conventional systems due to elimination of those environmental factors in RAS. Although all operation principles and many necessary components are exactly the same both freshwater and saltwater research, marine recirculating aquaculture systems are show few but important differences. As I mentioned before, ozone sterilizator can be used in marine RAS units as well as protein skimmer. The most known difference is protein skimmer used to remove organic compounds such as food and waste particles from water. Protein skimmer is used in saltwater systems for clarity by removing organic compounds, especially in city aquariums. They use all of these constantly. Also, insulation stamps, freshwater and saltwater tanks, pipes or pumps should be durable to environmental conditions, as I mentioned before. They selected from among hard wearing and corrosion resistant materials. And finally, I want to express our activities, what we are doing in our system. We have a recirculating aquaculture system production unit for Black Sea trout product, which is endemic species for the Eastern Black Sea. Our unit restored in 2005 as a full control recirculating system. Our system has 10 meter cube total water capacity. We carried out incubation of trout and larval grouping studies. In 2018, there had been a range of renovations, including the biological filter unit. This is final plan of our system. We have drum filter, biofilter, automatic filter, back filter, and ultraviolet. And water came from culture tanks, first to the tambour filter, after that biological filter. We used Nitrosomonas, Nitrobacter, and Lactobacillus species in the nitrification process. We use mechanical filters, back filter, automatic filter, and drum filters. Also, we use ultraviolet sterilizer for sterilization. Thank you for your listening. If you have any further questions, my mail addresses exist in the slide. You can mail me anytime. Thank you again.